Welcome to the InfoWars Nightly News. It is Tuesday, January 14th, 2014, and I'm Leanne McAdoo. Well, 450 pages of documents have just been declassified, and they prove what we've been telling you for years, that the president and top defense officials have lied and been lying to us about what they knew about Benghazi. Now, the documents show that just minutes after the consulate in Benghazi came under attack, the nation's top defense officials were informed that the event was a terrorist attack. And this means, of course, that the president and then Secretary of State Hillary Clinton also knew. So this, of course, raises the question of why for 2 weeks did the president and these other top military officials press this false narrative that the assault grew spontaneously out of a demonstration over an anti-Islam video that was produced in America. Numerous aides to the president and Secretary of State Hillary Clinton repeatedly told the public in the weeks following the murder of Ambassador Stevens and 3 other Americans that there was no evidence that the killings were the result of a premeditated terrorist attack. Of course, this was all going on while Obama was running for re-election in a very hotly contested bid. So it was only after he won re-election that disclosures exposed that this narrative was false and that they indeed lied. And of course, the Obama administration had to ultimately acknowledge that its early statements were untrue. And so while our president is given carte blanche to lie to the American public, and we continue to allow him to be in office, police are being given complete freedom to murder innocent people. And when we take it to a jury trial, juries are then allowing these guys to get away scot-free. The 2011 beating of a mentally disabled homeless man, Kelly Thomas, who was beaten, tasered, suffocated, and pistol-whipped by no less than 6 police officers, and all of this was caught on video. That has resulted in an acquittal for 2 police officers. And what's even more disturbing was that a jury found the 2 police officers not guilty on all charges of murder and manslaughter. And even though they can be heard on that videotape saying, "You see these fists? They are about to F you up." These cops maliciously beat this man on video for 20 minutes. It's a horrendous video. I can't even watch it. The man is pleading and screaming for life. He's calling out for his daddy. And the jury just decided that Thomas, coincidentally, you know, he chose to die of this undiagnosed heart condition in the hospital 5 days after he was beaten unconscious and he never regained consciousness. An attorney for one of those police officers said, "These peace officers were doing their job. They had no malice in their heart." Well, I am sorry, but we have not called these guys peace officers for a long time, and they're definitely not there to uphold the peace. But you know who else doesn't have malice in their hearts? Serial killers, cold-blooded killers, people who have no emotions. If you just listen to that man pleading on the videotape, to not be able to stop yourself or to figure out another way, 6 men beat him and were restraining him to just cuff the guy, put him in a cop car, but instead there's a huge pile of blood on the ground and these guys are just getting their rocks off of beating this man who was mentally disabled and homeless. When you are on a jury, you have the opportunity to decide if the law is just, not whether or not the police officers broke the law, but whether or not their actions are just. You get to decide. So if you consent to this kind of action, like these people on this jury did, if you consent to this kind of tyranny, then you are consenting to this cesspool of corruption that has saturated our society. This is a reflection of the society we live in, the way these police officers were, and then the way the jury just allowed and consented. They're only going to act like this if you give them your consent. And this is what's creating the society where 6,000 reports of child abuse and neglect go uninvestigated by the Child Protective Services. Another government agency that's totally run amok with corruption and incompetence has been proven to be so bad at doing their job in Arizona that Governor Jan Brewer has signed an order that completely abolished the state's Child Protective Services Agency. She absorbed it and replaced it with a new division. Now, this move comes in response to an internal investigation that revealed 6,000 reports of child abuse or neglect that were never investigated by CPS. So basically, they're just sitting around getting paid to not do their jobs. They're very quick to snatch your kids away, but then they're never going to follow up on any reports of abuse, where I've already covered in plenty of cases where foster kids are abused or put into these really awful situations with child sex trafficking and porn and getting in, you know, pimps go after these kids because they're not looked after. And here, at least in Arizona, the governor is doing something about it. Hopefully, you know, she'll be able to do a better job than what the CPS there was doing, but then she absorbed this responsibility into her office. So we'll have to wait and see if she does a little bit better of a job in the Child Protective Services there. And in even more injustice, man, I'm sorry, the news today is filled with it. The Supreme Court hands Monsanto a victory over farmers on their GMO seed patents. They now have the ability to sue farmers whose fields may be inadvertently contaminated. Now, this means the high court left intact a federal appeals court decision that had thrown out a lawsuit by the organic seed growers and over 80 other plaintiffs against Monsanto. It was just seeking to challenge the company's aggressive claims on their GMO patents, as well as just trying to get Monsanto from suing anyone whose field is inadvertently contaminated. Now, Monsanto has filed over 140 lawsuits against farmers for planting the seeds without permission, and they've also settled around 700 other cases without suing. Now, the appeals court based their decision on Monsanto's promise not to sue farmers whose crops contained trace amounts of the company's biotechnology products. So Monsanto can basically patent their seed for profit, and then they can sue you rather than allowing you to sue them for they contaminate your organic field and they're going to sue you. That's like if I'm spray painting my car in my driveway and some of my paint splatters on your house, and then I sue you for having my paint on your house. It's ridiculous. And then Monsanto is one of the companies that's trying to get our bought and paid for Congress to fast track the TPP so that they can take this kind of overarching power to do whatever they want, this lawlessness, into countries all over the world. And then they don't even have to go through the courts, the local courts. They will go to international tribunals and obviously decide in favor of these huge corporations, because it's becoming clear every day who really runs this country and who really pulls Obama's puppet strings. And in other rulings that are running counter to the Constitution, a court has dealt a blow to anonymity and the First Amendment. The Virginia Court of Appeals ruled that Yelp users have no right to be anonymous when they post negative comments about a business online. Now, even though the Supreme Court has recognized on numerous occasions the right to speak anonymously and has associated this right to the First Amendment. Now, one case said, protections for anonymous speech are vital to democratic discourse. Anonymity is a shield from the tyranny of the majority. It thus exemplifies the purpose behind the Bill of Rights and of the First Amendment in particular, to protect unpopular individuals from retaliation at the hand of an intolerant society. And our online anonymity, it continues to be jeopardized. And with that, private web browsers are seeing a really huge increase in web traffic. You know, just because you Google something doesn't mean you have to actually go to google.com and backdoor all of your information to the NSA. Now, StartPage spokesperson and privacy expert Dr. Catherine Albrecht says that every time Edward Snowden shares a new revelation about government spying, they get an influx of new users. Their privacy policy is very simple. Albrecht says, we don't collect any information. Nada, zilch, zero. No IP addresses are recorded, and no tracking cookies are used. If any government comes knocking, there's nothing for them to get, period. Now, the same, of course, cannot be said for Google, which has a very detailed relationship with U.S. intelligence. And while you may be browsing privately, just know that businesses are starting to build shopper profiles on you using new sensors that track your phones. Turnstile Solutions has provided businesses with sensors that follow signal emitted from Wi-Fi-enabled smartphones. This allows these businesses to track habits like traveling from a yoga studio to a restaurant, to a coffee shop, sports stadiums, hotels, and what nightclubs you might want to go to. A business owner said that instead of offering a general promotion that may or may not hit a nerve, we can promote specifically to the customer's taste. Now, these location trackers are bound to ignite privacy concerns because, of course, they can track whether you're going to see a specialist or a hospital and then sell that data to marketers. And just as a heads up, the U.S. doesn't need to get your consent in order to track you. Isn't that wonderful? Well, we'll be right back. I've got an update on Obamacare.
My friends, Alex Jones here to tell you about some of the most important information concerning you and your family's health. Radiation levels have more than doubled in the last 60 years in the Northern Hemisphere from all of the nuclear testing and radiological accidents. Radioactive contamination is now in most of the food supply. There's only two ways to avoid this. Move south of the equator or properly protect your thyroid with nascent iodine. Looking to protect my family, I've done deep research. Nascent iodine is the purest, cleanest, absolute best form of iodine to protect yourself and your family. It's made right here in the USA, completely non-GMO. I searched out the best quality and now have developed a double-strength form of nascent iodine, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Nascent iodine is on record as one of the only safe ways to detox from fluoride poisoning. Survival Shield Nascent Iodine. Secure your super high-quality nascent iodine today at InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Introducing Pro One, all of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquametics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filter today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
Welcome back. Well, we've been covering the stories of thousands of American families who have lost their health insurance coverage once Obamacare forced their insurance companies to cancel their plan. Well, one of those families was the Daverts. But the Daverts aren't like any other American family. Their twin children have brittle bone disease, as well as the mother, and the father has cerebral palsy. This is a family who needs frequent medical care. Now, the parents had been covered under Medicare, but that didn't cover their children, and their children were both previously insured with a plan that wouldn't exceed $2,500 annually. Well, now, thanks to the new Unaffordable Care Act, the family who needs frequent medical care are looking at a plan where they'll pay $10,000 annually for their children. And Mrs. Davert says, you know, we go to the doctor quite frequently. We're definitely going to meet that $10,000 every single year. But what's even worse is that when Mrs. Davert checked to make sure that her family was signed up for this more expensive coverage, because they had to sign up for it, she needed to cover her kids, she learned that her application had been lost. And then she made several other attempts to sign up again. But she learned then, once she was able to finally sign up, that her children had been denied coverage. I'm sorry, what? Denied coverage? I thought this was the exact reason why we have government mandated insurance. This was the big lie that the American people were told, which made people vote for Obamacare so that families and especially families who really needed insurance would be covered, and insurers wouldn't be allowed to deny them coverage or to charge them exorbitant rates for actually needing to go to the doctor. And here is a perfect example of why this is going to fail, why this doesn't work. Here we have a family who is living proof that once again, the American people were lied to. We have a family who liked their plan and wanted to keep their plan and can't, and now they've been denied coverage. So we'll have to keep you updated on just exactly what this family is going to do. But this is further proof that the government does not care about getting healthcare coverage for everyone. What they care about is those two pennies you have to rub together, and they want to figure out a way to take half. Youth enrollment is vital to the success of Obamacare, but the young and healthy just aren't lining up to pay exorbitant premiums on plans they probably won't use just to offset the cost for sicker consumers. In fact, only 24% of the 2.2 million people who've signed up for Obamacare were between 18 and 35, far below the 38% needed to make healthcare reform a success. If the young and healthy fail to sign up before the March deadline, insurers will have to raise prices next year. But what if people still fail to sign up for Obamacare next year, especially at a higher rate? Will the Affordable Care Act implode? Will insurers throw their hands in the air in defeat? Not likely, considering that over the next decade, more than $1 trillion is expected to funnel from American taxpayers through Washington to health insurance companies. We will see a massive transfer of wealth occur in this classically fascist arrangement. You know, fascism, where a few elites and the biggest corporations collaborate with the government to bring everybody else down. But insurers also aren't concerned with low enrollment numbers because of the risk corridor program. It's built into Obamacare and it limits the overall losses for insurers. In fact, American taxpayers are on the hook for 78% of any losses accrued by managed healthcare. So just like the bankster bailout, where we gave trillions of dollars to the criminals who tanked our economy, taxpayers may now have to bail out the health insurance agency if and when the law fails. We told you, the Affordable Care Act was written by the insurance companies for the insurance companies. Conservatives and Tea Party Republicans agree that Obamacare will fail, and some insist Obamacare has a built-in failure mechanism that will give rise to a coordinated lefty push for single payer, a system in which the government, instead of private insurers, pays for all healthcare costs. Considering that about 80% of all Obamacare enrollees have already received federal assistance to defray the cost of coverage, those subsidies which are paid for by the taxpayer, and now taxpayers are also on the hook to cover any losses for insurers, well, it seems we've already morphed into a single-payer system. And that single-payer is you. All right, well, stay tuned after the break. David Knight is going to check in with Jakari Jackson and the rest of the crew, and you're not going to believe where they're finding this radiation now.
Symbols are powerful, and the globalists have hijacked the symbols of America. They've turned them into their own symbols. Well, we are restoring the idea of the true republic, not the counterfeit globalist empire, by promoting the icon George Washington and others. That's why we're rolling out an 100% made in America line of incredible pro-liberty apparel. We are repopularizing liberty. We are helping fellow Americans rediscover what made this country great. We are the spirit of 1776. We are 1776 worldwide. We are all brothers and sisters in arms in the animating contest of liberty in the long march towards humanity's ultimate destiny of freedom. Visit madein1776.com today and vote with your dollars to promote truly made in America, high quality products, and promote the ideals of liberty. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
Welcome back. Now, if you remember, in the aftermath of Fukushima, we saw a debris field that some people described about the size of the state of Texas. And, of course, currents are going to bring that to the west coast of the U.S. And they predicted that would be happening right about now. Then we learned of elevated radiation readings on the west coast. So we sent a team of reporters from InfoWars to report on this. And Jakari Jackson and crew have been going up and down the west coast. And he's checking in with us with his latest report. Well, Jakari, what are your latest findings?
Well, David, you know, we've been on our West Coast tour. We've gone as far north as Portland, Oregon. We're reaching the final stretch right now. We're in Playa del Rey, which is just a little bit south of Los Angeles at Dockweiler Beach. And last night, David, we stopped by an actually functioning nuclear power facility. This is the Diablo Canyon Nuclear Power Facility. And out there, we found radiation levels to be around 72 or around 70 CPMs. That's counts per minute, keeping in mind that north of here at Half Moon Bay at Surfers Beach, they say the norm is around 30 CPMs. And at Half Moon Beach at Surfers Beach, Half Moon Bay Surfers Beach, the radiation levels we found were in excess of 370, which goes to say that an actually functioning nuclear power facility has less ambient radiation than Surfers Beach.
Wow, that's amazing. And yet even there, you're seeing what is about double what everybody says should be background radiation.
Yes, David, out here, the ambient is around 72 CPMs counts per minute, still higher than what it should be, but nowhere near what we encountered at Half Moon Bay. And David, I want to make another note about the nuclear power facility at Diablo Canyon. Out there, we caught a fresh fish. A gentleman was on the dock. He caught a fresh fish, and he let us scan it right there on the spot. That fish registered to be about 60 CPMs counts per minute, double of what it's supposed to be at Half Moon Bay.
Well, that's amazing. You know, what we've got is essentially a new normal that is anywhere from 2 to 2.5 times what it's been in the past. So we're looking at things that are about 60 to 70, 75 CPM, and the normal background radiation has been 30 CPM. But in, as you said, in places like Half Moon Bay, it was 370. So it's quite a bit higher. Now, from here, where are you headed? You're south of L.A. You're going further down to San Diego?
Yes. So, you know, from Portland, Oregon, all the way down to San Diego. We'll hit a few beaches along the way, maybe a few other spots, and be on the plane back to Austin, Texas tomorrow afternoon, David.
Well, it certainly is an interesting finding that you've got higher radiation at the at that beach that started
surface
everything.
Beach.
Yeah, surface beach. You got higher radiation there than you do outside of a nuclear power plant. But it's also interesting that the background radiation is so elevated everywhere.
Oh, that's very true, David. Even up in the Redwoods, we saw radiation twice of what it should be, according to the Half Moon Bay standards.
Well, that's interesting. Well, we're certainly interested. I think people need to understand that this is what's going on there. This is something that's not being reported on by the government. It's not something that's being reported on by the media. They just order extra potassium iodide pills for themselves quietly.
That's right. That's exactly right.
Quietly. Well, thank you very much, Jakari. We'll be looking
forward
to some more information. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Well, we have some more information about those shocking radiation readings, a comparison between the nuclear power plant and the beach. And Jakari Jackson has a man on the street interview with the people of California. Are they more concerned about fantasy football and the fantasy environmentalism of global warming than they are about real radiation levels increasing, even in the background radiation, increasing 2 to 2.5 times normal? Here are those reports.
From Portland, Oregon to now right outside Avila Beach, California, our documentation of West Coast radiation has brought us here to the Diablo Canyon Nuclear Power Facility. We've been doing this in light of top experts and researchers coming out with the information that a radioactive plume from Fukushima will contact the United States West Coast sometime in 2014. Now, we've been going all up and down the coast, getting our numbers and checking the radiation levels. So we came here to contrast those numbers with the actual nuclear power facility. And we found the ambient radiation using our Geiger counter to be about 60 CPMs or counts per minute. North of here in Half Moon Bay, the norm is considered to be about 30 CPMs or counts per minute. When we ventured to Half Moon Bay, we found radiation levels in excess of 370. So even though this is an active nuclear power facility, the radiation levels at Half Moon Bay are much higher than what we encountered here. We also went to the Humboldt Nuclear Power Facility that's in the process of being decommissioned. It should be fully decommissioned by the end of 2015. Those radiation levels there are still significantly lower than what we encountered in Half Moon Bay, which begs the question that if an active nuclear power facility and a facility that's in the process of being decommissioned have significantly lower levels of radiation than Half Moon Bay, why is this not a national news story? Why is this not an international news story that these power plants are registering lower radiation than what is being found in Half Moon Bay? Why aren't people running through the streets? Why isn't the government doing something about this? Yes, the local news is reporting on this to an extent. You know, they always want to spin this and say this is global warming, it's this, it's that. I don't know. It could be thorium, it could be radium. Whatever it is, it's high levels of radiation at Half Moon Bay. So we'll continue to go south and find other radiation levels, hopefully nothing near in excess of what we found at Half Moon Bay. But an active nuclear power facility has less radiation than Half Moon Bay. The people need to be told. Go to InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv for more reports. Reports have surfaced from top researchers that a plume of Fukushima radiation will contact the United States sometime in 2014. With that in mind, we've been on a West Coast tour. We've gone as far north as Portland, Oregon. Now we're back down in sunny California because right beneath this location, just a little bit south of San Francisco at Half Moon Bay, we encountered our highest radiation levels, over 10 times what's considered normal for that location. So we came up here to San Francisco, not too far away, to see if these people are even aware of these issues. Hi, excuse me, how are you guys doing today? Are you guys aware of the bioaccumulation, the excessive level of radiation just a little bit south of here in Half Moon Bay?
No.
Are you a local resident?
I am. Yeah.
And you haven't heard about these radiation levels?
No, I haven't.
No, but I know about Half Moon Bay. That's a place that's always the wettest place in the U.S.
Oh, is that a fact?
No, I don't know.
Are you a local resident?
Yeah.
And this is your first time hearing this information?
Yes.
Are you a local resident here?
Yes.
And you haven't heard about this?
What is this for?
Well, this is for InfoWars.com. We're trying to tell the people out there about the excessive levels of radiation that are going on just a little bit south of here.
No, I haven't heard anything about them.
The highest levels of radiation have been centered right around here at Half Moon Bay, just a little bit south of here.
Oh, that's horrible.
Sorry, I don't want to be on camera or quoted. Thank you.
I don't like to be filmed without my permission.
Okay, sir, I'll tell you that the NSA films you every day through your laptop, and also these traffic cameras film you too. So they're filming you without your permission too. Just be aware of that, sir. Have you heard about the melting starfish?
No, that I have not.
No, actually.
You have not?
Mm-mm.
Well, sir, let me just ask you this. What type of information are you really into? What gets you up in the morning? What's the first thing you look for in the morning?
I do, you know, have an interest in global warming, those kinds of large-scale environmental issues, but I can't say as I've heard of the localized radiation thing.
The government has purchased about 14 million doses of potassium iodide. Now, you use that to protect your body from radiation. Would it concern you to know that they're buying all this radiation protection and not informing the general public?
Sure. Seems like they obviously know something we don't then.
Would it be too much to speculate that maybe the government knows something that they're not sharing with the general public?
I think that's too... I could not make that link.
I don't want it to be a Republican's conspiracy to take over the United States again.
A Republican conspiracy? Is it a conspiracy that Steve Weiss, an electrical engineer who makes Geiger counters, went out there and found radiation levels 1,400% normal, higher than normal? Is that a conspiracy, sir?
I don't know if it's a conspiracy. It's just an observation. Mm-hmm.
After meeting all the awake, vibrant, lovely people just a little bit southwest of here in Half Moon Bay. I'm somewhat discouraged that about half the people we talked to today just had no interest in these issues. I guess they're more concerned with the 49ers or about their trendiness, their new iPhone, or whatever else. But these are real issues, and you need to take action. Sometimes just walking out here and talking to people can wake people up. Some people were very receptive of this information. And for the other people who may have been on vacation and just didn't care, we met people in Half Moon Bay who were on vacation, and they cared just as much as the people who live right there in Half Moon Bay. So stay tuned to InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv as we bring you more reports on our West Coast tour.
Well, that's it for tonight's news. Now, if you would like to help Prison Planet TV support our operation, help us to file these kinds of reports and investigations that the mainstream media is not doing, that the government won't talk about, you can become a Prison Planet TV subscriber. Just one subscription will let you share this with at least 10 other people simultaneously. It's a great way to help wake people up, help inform the population, and to wake people up from their apathy, and it supports our operation. Well, we'll be back tomorrow at 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern.
Tune in to PrisonPlanet.tv for an extended broadcast.
Now you can watch The Alex Jones Show live as it happens at InfoWars.com/show.
You'll find links to all of our content there and a free 15-day trial for Prison Planet TV.
More than 60 movies and documentaries all in one place at InfoWars.com/show.
Mr. and Mrs. America, turn them all in. Those are the words of the gun-grabbing Senator Dianne Feinstein, who does not want you to have your, quote, pleasure weapons.
America has to step up. The mothers, the women, the men of America have to make a decision as to whether their personal pleasure is more important than the general welfare.
Now, we're here on the West Coast in search of excessively high levels of radiation. Our search has brought us here to San Francisco, right near Fisherman's Wharf. And the boys and I were coming out of the hotel this morning, and we couldn't help but chuckle at this airsoft shooting range right here behind me. Now, airsoft is used to train for target practice and things such as that. But in the South Southwest, where we hail from, we go whole hog and shoot real guns. And, you know, the gun grabbers in here in California do not want you to be armed. They want you to be disarmed. They don't want you to have your concealed carry. They don't want you to have your, quote, military style rifle with military characteristics. Most of these people can't even tell you what a military characteristic is. And if you think this gun grabbing is just going on here in the state of California, it's not just here. In New Jersey, they want children to register BB guns. That's I'm not making that up. Go look it up for yourself. They want children to register BB guns to just be able to shoot in the backyard, shoot the cans off the fence or whatnot. So, as much as I'm concerned about encountering excessively high levels of radiation, such as we did at Half Moon Bay, just a little bit southwest of here, I'm not too much concerned about being shot by this disarmed populace. You can find more reports at PrisonPlanet.tv and InfoWars.com.